Thank you. I just got off a plane to come here this afternoon to be with my sister, Celia Cruz, the queen of our music.
Where'd you just come from?
I just came from Florida, doing universities, workshops, and seminars. I do that all over the country, teaching the young people coming up about Latin music and Latin jazz. But I'll be opening up with the Blue Note here in New York with Celia, my sister.
Okay.
And tomorrow I leave for Mexico. Anyway.
Oh, that still sounds wonderful.
Yeah.
I was just reading over something from Santana, and Oye Como Va was your tune.
Well, I do a joke in the show all the time. I'll be brief anyway. I always tell the people that everybody used to come up to me many years ago when he recorded Oye Como Va. I did it 12 years after I did. So the people used to come up to me and say, Tito, could you play me Santana's tune? I said, I don't play Santana's music. You know. Then my managers called me, Mr. Ralph Mercado, told me, you should play it because you're the composer, which he did give me credit. So I told him, well, nobody knows who composers are. Whitney Houston records, everybody does. Nobody knows who wrote the tune. They only know the interpreter. That was on a Friday.
Yeah, yeah, but the deal is. Okay, go ahead.
That was on a Friday. Okay. Monday, I got me a check in the mail. When I got the check, I've been playing Santana music all the time.
That's what I was going to say. The real deal is who wrote the tune.
That's right.
That's right.
Well, people don't know who write tunes, you know, Cole Porter, Gershwin, whatever. But anyway, thanks to him.
Tell me about the Grammys now.
Well, Grammys, we have a new Latin jazz category coming up this year for the first time, thanks to Mr. Eddie Palmieri.
Okay.
My brother there, he blah, 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 he got it. And this is the first time we're getting a Latin jazz category. I'm very happy about it. I hope I win. I don't know. I'm in there.
Have you any Grammys already?
Well, I have 5 Grammys already and 10 nominations.
Oh, whoa,
yeah.
Whoa.
Oh, yeah. I've been in there.
What's your latest album now?
My latest album I'll be recording will be my 105th album now. Yeah. It's going to be a Latin jazz album. My last one is In Session, which has all my Latin, golden Latin jazz all-stars. We're all big stars on that album, and it's doing very well.
So what's your projection of this coming year and your work? And you know you're going to Mexico, and what else are you going to be doing? You doing any more movies or anything?
Yeah. Well,
are you really?
Well, I was in the movie Mambo Kings.
Mambo Kings, yeah,
right. Now we're going to do the Mambo Queens.
Are you serious?
No. Yeah, I don't know who's going to be the queen. But anyway, the thing is that our music is getting a lot of recognition throughout the world, and I'm very happy about that at my age and the years that I've put into the field, and that's very important.
What is your native home?
Well, Puerto Rico. I'm Puerto Rican, really. My parents, yes. And my ambition is to be the first Latin band to play on the moon.
Oh, and I think you're going to make it, too.
By the year 2000-something, whatever.
Yeah, I hope so.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay.
Bajo la dirección del maestro Tito Puente y con la participación de Giovanni Hidalgo, Andy González, Dave Valentín, Paquito de Rivera, Hilton Ruiz, Claudio Roditi, Ignacio Berroa, Mario Rivera y Mongo Santamaría. Se grabó en vivo en el legendario Village Gate de Nueva York, centro de entretenimiento musical reconocido en el mundo entero. Este disco compacto que logra proyectar la electrizante energía de los ritmos de la salsa y el jazz, que cuando se unen, conocemos como Latin Jazz. Una excelente selección de temas musicales logra indudablemente hacer de esta grabación algo único y especial. New Arrival, Sunflower, Afro Blue, Skin Jam, I Loves You Porgy, Oye Como Va y Milestones. especial que indudablemente justifica su título. Tito Puente's Golden Latin Jazz All-Stars, live at the Bullet Gate. Se han reunido músicos de la talla y reconocimiento internacional como los que aquí participan. Y nunca antes se ha llevado al mercado una grabación tan excitante como esta, que sin lugar a dudas pasará al transcurrir de los años a convertirse en un clásico del jazz latino.